Before we dive into MATLAB and Simulink, let us first take a moment to understand what we are trying to implement. On the screen, we have a state space model for a mass spring damper system, and we are to design an LQR controller that will drive the system to a position of 10 meters, given that the maximum force our actuator can apply is 100 Newton. LQR is a pulse set feedback controller that solves an optimization problem to compute an optimal gain matrix K, which minimizes the cost function J. J has two parts, the part that penalizes the closed loop error and the part that penalizes the control input that drives the plant. The extent to which we penalize the two parts is determined by how we relatively tune our weighting parameters Q and R. So Q is just an N by N diagonal matrix, where N is the number of states of the system, and R is an M by M diagonal matrix, where M is the number of inputs. So for our mass spring damper system, our Q will just be 2 by 2, and our R will be a scalar since we have a single input. Q position determines the extent to which we want to finalize the error in position. Q velocity determines the extent to which we want to minimize the error in velocity. And R force determines the level to which we want to minimize our applied control input. If your actuator can handle a large amount of control input, you can prioritize minimizing the error over the control input by setting Q to be relatively higher than R. Conversely, if the actuator can handle less control input, you will set R to be higher than Q. So we can compute our optimal gain matrix K in MATLAB by using the function LQR, and the arguments it takes are the A matrix, B matrix, and the weighting parameters Q and R. Before we jump to MATLAB and Simulink, let us see some critical steps that we need for our implementation. U is just KE, as you can see, K times E, and our E is just the reference minus state, so we are feeding back the full state of the plant. This is where an LQR gets its name for full state feedback controller, since we are feeding back the entire states. So substituting this control input into the open loop state space model, we have our closed loop state space model. Factorizing like terms, we will have A minus BKX plus BKR, and we have A bar X plus B bar R, and this is our closed loop state space model. So you can see the input to the system is not U now, because we are dealing with closed loop. So the input is the reference or the desired output for our system. And our A bar and B bar are just A minus BK, and B bar is just BK. So if you look clearly, what we are actually doing is K1 is multiplying the error in the position, while K2 is multiplying the error in the velocity, which is the derivative of the error in position. So literally, LQR is analogous to PD controller. So no matter how we tune our K1 and K2, we'll always have some steady state error, because we are not summing up the error over time, which is done by an integral term. So in order to fully eliminate the steady state error, we need to compute a feed-forward scaling term which will be multiplied to our reference, and we'll see that implementation in MATLAB. A, B, C, D matrices for the system. If I run the section, I will have the matrices on the workspace. So the first thing to do in the design of any full state feedback controller is to check the controllability and observability of the system. So you can only go ahead with the design if your system is controllable and if your system is observable. To check the controllability of your system, the controllability matrix has to have full rank, and in MATLAB we compute the controllability matrix using the CTRB function, which takes the arguments A and B, and we compute our observability matrix using the OBSV function, which takes the argument A and C. And full ranks means the rank of the matrix is equal to the number of states. So the observability matrix and the controllability matrix has to have a rank of 2 for us to go ahead with our design. So if I run this section, you can see RCO and ROV from the command window, they are all two, which means my system is controllable and my system is observable, and I can go ahead with my design. So the next part is the tuning parameters. As you can see, I have tuned my Q position to be 1, Q velocity to be 1, and R to be 0.1. That means I'm giving more priority to minimizing the error in my state than minimizing my control input. So the optimal gain matrix can be computed using the LQR command as earlier on explained. So the last part is the computation of our pitfall scaling time KR, which is done using the DC gain of our closed loop system. So the closed loop system is obtained using the SS command, which is for state space model. And for our closed loop, our A matrix is just A minus BK, our B matrix is BK, our C matrix is the same with the open loop state space model, and our D will be 2 by 2 zeros now because we have a closed loop system with two references, that is the reference position and the reference velocity. So the reciprocal of the DC gain at the respective channel of our references will give us our scaling time KR. So let me run the code in its entirety. So as you can see, I have my K and I have my KR, and I already have my model matrices. So let me just go to Simulink and see the implementation. So this is my LQR full set feedback loop. As you can see, I have my reference, which is a subsystem. If I double click into it, I have my reference position, which is 10, and my reference velocity, which is 0 meter per second, because I want it to step at 10. And I have my gain matrix K, which I've already computed in MATLAB. So Simulink will read it from MATLAB. And this is my system. So I have my A, B, C, D matrix already in MATLAB. And these are the initial conditions at 0 meters and 0 meter per second. I have my scaling time KR, which is multiplied with the reference. And I have three scopes here, one for visualizing the computed control input, one for visualizing the position tracking, and one for visualizing my velocity tracking. So if I run the model, so as you can see, I was able to achieve 0 CD state error for the position tracking, as I was able to reach 10 meters, and I was also able to achieve 0 CD state error for the velocity tracking because it's set at 0 meters per second. However, the transient response is a bit slow, and if I have room in my actuator, I should be able to speed up the transient response. So for my actuator, you can see the maximum input generated by the controller is about 37.4, and my actuator has a limit of 100 Newton. So I can further finalize my error in order to obtain a fast transient response. So going back to MATLAB, because penalizing the velocity is like penalizing the control input, I will give more emphasis on penalizing the error in position. So if I change this to say 100 and run it again, so you can see my gain K will change and my KR will also change. So going back to Simulink, if I run the model with the new gains, so you can see now the transient response is much faster, and we are also able to achieve 0 CD state error. If you look at the velocity, it reaches up to 20 something meters per second, which is comparatively higher than the previous gain. However, the control input generated by the controller has exceeded the limit of our actuator, which is between minus 100 to 100 meters. We have attained up to 317 meters. So that means we have finalized our error too much. We have to reduce the finalization. So let us go back and tune our Q a bit. So let me reduce the finalization of the error in position to 5. So if I run, I will have a new KR and a new K. So going back to Simulink, so running with the new gains, so as you can see, I have a pretty well tracking and a 0 CD state error, and as you can see, I'm still within my limit of -100 to 100. So I think this one is a satisfactory response. If you want to see the implementation of PID in Simulink as well as its explanation, watch the video on the right. If you want to see the explanation and implementation of full state feedback controller using pulse placement, watch the video on the left. Like and subscribe to the channel if you learned something. Thank you for watching.